Guys, come here! Did you see it? The trailer for the new film Fantastic Beasts, The Crimes of Grindelwald? I was so excited when I saw that Nicholas Flamel makes an appearance.
Nicolas Flamel.
Jacob Kowalski.
Oh,
you don't look a day over 375.
Now, in case you don't remember, in the Harry Potter books, Flamel was an alchemist, a person who tries to make the sorcerer's stone or philosopher's stone. The stone can turn base metals like lead into gold and also produce the elixir of life. And according to the first Harry Potter book, Flamel was the only alchemist ever to succeed in this quest. But here's the thing, Nicholas Flamel was a real guy. He was a bookseller, notary, and philanthropist in 14th century Paris. Now, whether or not he actually made the Philosopher's Stone is up for debate, but here is the myth behind the man.
Legend has it that Flamel acquired a strange book with a brass cover filled with symbols he couldn't understand. So he set off on a quest to decode it. In Spain, he found a scholar who helped him translate the manuscript. The scholar died before finishing the translation, but Flamel apparently learned enough to decode the rest himself. The manuscript was known as the Book of Abraham the Jew, and it was written to help the Jewish people pay tribute to the Romans by turning base metals into gold. So with the book translated, Flamel and his wife, Pernell, made gold for themselves. Flamel then hid the secrets he learned from the book in public art. He encoded the knowledge in pictures that decorated a church building. For example, he painted two entwined dragons, one that represented sulfur and the other mercury, which form part of the formula he used to create the Philosopher's Stone.
So that was the legend, but there are real books published in Nicholas Flamel's name that tell his account of creating the stone. Recently, I had the great pleasure of seeing some of them, along with many other volumes that could easily be found on Dumbledore's bookshelf. Whoa. Steve, is this the library at Hogwarts?
No, actually, this is the History of Medicine Division at the National Library of Medicine in Bethesda, Maryland.
Steve Greenberg is the head of rare books and early manuscripts here at the library.
Which house at Hogwarts are you in?
I think I'd be a Ravenclaw.
I mean, they are very studious.
That's right, though I do have my Slytherin days.
Slytherin or not, I was excited to meet Steve, since the library has two books that allegedly contain the alchemical writings of Nicholas Flamel.
This one is the older one. It's from 1612, and it's in French. And it talks about three treatises in how to convert elements to other elements. And you can see one of them is written by Nicholas Flamel. And since this was kind of not knowledge to be shared easily, sometimes the books get to be an awful lot smaller.
Why was this information so secret?
Well, it's kind of magic because you are transforming things. And magic was a little sketchy. You didn't want everyone to know the secrets. Besides, if there was too much gold, it wouldn't be worth as much anymore.
Right. You have to account for inflation.
Exactly.
Now, you might be wondering why a medical library has books on alchemy and magic at all.
Chemistry, really, and alchemy are almost the same thing. Alchemy is just chemistry that doesn't work. And when you go back far enough, you find that chemistry and alchemy get mixed up together.
Is there anything that the alchemists discovered or learned that actually is applied in science today?
A great deal. They were very good at studying the individual properties of elements and the fact that if you mixed two things together, they would react in the same way every time, and there was a consistency.
Flamel isn't the only Harry Potter figure to make an appearance at the library. This unfinished book is by Paracelsus, the discoverer of Parseltongue, who was also a real pharmacologist and alchemist.
Did we mention that he actually got killed in a bar fight?
No!
Apparently so.
The library has many other books that blur the lines between science and magic, like this one from 1485.
Can't believe I just got to touch that.
Well, this is a book for what you at Hogwarts would call an herbologist. But this is certainly for a botanist, though they wouldn't have used that word. It's telling you what the plants are good for, how to grow them, and how to make sure you have more next year. And there are some real plans in here, and there are some plans that we're not quite sure what they were.
Herbology definitely would have been my favorite class at Hogwarts. Hufflepuff for life!
In the library at Hogwarts, there are books that are considered dangerous, like the Monster Book of Monsters, mm-hmm. which, you know, could actually bite your hand if mm-hmm. you're not careful. I'm assuming you don't have any books that are dangerous to our physical beings here at the library, but do you have books here that were maybe ever considered dangerous from a moral perspective or spiritual perspective?
We do have one. So this is a book from 1494. It's called the Malleus Maleficarum, the Hammer of Witches. And officially, it's a book to help you determine if someone is a witch. But it also has a lot of information that only witches would know so that you knew how to find them. So if you were found with a copy of this book, you'd have some explaining to do.
The Hammer of Witches could totally be a textbook in Professor Flitwick's class. In fact, the National Library of Medicine has books that could have been used in any Hogwarts class, from potions to care of magical creatures.
Do you think that books are magical?
I do, because you always learn something unexpected from a good book.
Getting to hang out with Steve and see the collection at the National Library of Medicine got me thinking about the differences between science and magic. A woman boiling willow bark to cure headaches in the 1500s would have been called a witch, but today we'd call her a doctor or a chemist. Willow bark contains similar pain-relieving compounds as aspirin. And while modern doctors and engineers may not have created the Philosopher's Stone, they have developed innovations that vastly improve the length and quality of our lives. And I have to think that to Nicholas Flamel, modern science might seem like magic.
Science magic show, science magic show, science magic show.